Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I want to talk about quarterly and monthly planning. Because I worked in the corporate environment for the first decade and a half of my adult life, I got very accustomed to the year being broken down into not just into months, but also into quarters. And there's something about being able to plan things that need to happen within the next 3 months rather than within the next 4 weeks that make it feel more attainable. Plus, you know, sometimes there's things that we need 2 or 3 months for, like building and breaking habits. So after my master plan spreads, I get to my quarter one planning spread. There are a few things that I know will have to be done each quarter, so I went ahead and put those in on the computer before printing the pages, the car maintenance and the housekeeping. Yes, there's a daily housekeeping list too, but these are the big things, the tasks that only need to be done between 1 and 4 times each year rather than every month or every week or every day. And same thing with the car maintenance. I don't need to get my oil changed every month. I don't need to clean the windows and vacuum it out every month. Well, I probably should, but I do it once a quarter. And then I added the car loan tracker because I'm getting really close. It'll be paid off in July. So it's really exciting. It's been really exciting to see that number dwindle down, and then it'll be even lower in quarter two and quarter three. So that's been something fun to have in there. And then the other two boxes on this page are more for brainstorming or brain dumping. Some of the things to do and see are ideas of things I'd like to do, and some of them are must-dos. And then, of course, there's no way I can afford to eat at all the restaurants listed here in the next 2 months, because, I mean, we're already at the end of January, and I haven't eaten out once yet this month. And it's more of a wish list than a to-do list. And it's something that I will probably end up transferring to it's called a collection page, but a page in another part of the planner where I just keep writing down all the different restaurants around town that I'd like to try. The big piece for quarterly planning is my SMART goal for the quarter. And I'll link to my class on goal setting in the description box below. This is something that ties in with my master plan focus areas, and something that can be completed in a 3 month span of time. And this first quarter, it's getting myself onto a structured schedule for the workday. More than just my work hours are 9 to 6, but actually following a plan for blocks of productivity time with scheduled breaks and with a plan for what to do during those scheduled breaks. And in addition to tying it back to several master plan categories, I've also written out specific action steps for myself to keep it top of mind as I go through the quarter while I'm planning my months and weeks. And that includes doing a weekly review and evaluation of what worked and what didn't, how I did with the schedule, making revisions if necessary, and so on. And this is with specific results in mind. The main ones being that the schedule becomes a habit, and my work and overall productivity levels increase, and my body clock resets to the specific sleep and wake times that I have set for myself. Then we move into the month overview calendar. I like having a month at a glance calendar, but as you can see, I don't write a whole lot on it. Everything is personal appointments or activities. I keep all of my work stuff on my work Outlook calendar. And then I also put in any of these appointments into my personal Gmail calendar, and if it falls during the work day, I send an invitation to my work address so that I can have it on my work calendar as well. I like to have visual reminders of things, and I like having it on my Gmail calendar because then my phone will send me an electronic reminder for when I don't have this planner in front of me or I'm not looking at my work calendar. So it's a lot of redundancy, but it works for me. At the end of each month, I sit down at the computer and I pull up the events calendar from the local newspaper as well as the events section of Facebook, and I look for activities coming up to do during the month that's coming. Because I moved to this city only a little more than a year ago, I'm still trying to plug into the community. And I enjoy knowing what kinds of events and presentations the local museums, historic sites, the historic society, the theater, that they're doing that I might be interested in going to. And then all of that gets put into this monthly calendar. So this is more of an idea of events to attend or actual appointments that I have set. Not all of these are set in stone. For example, I ended up not going to this Historic Society presentation on Monday because it was 15 degrees and icy. And we had had snow over the weekend, so I didn't feel safe getting out and driving at night. But doctor appointments, Facebook Live, town hall meetings for the county government and the city government, things like, it's nice to just have it in an overview. Because once I have my overview done, then I get into the nitty-gritty of planning the month. So during the last week of the month, in addition to looking up all of those events, I also sit down and start filling out this monthly plan spread. Now, for January, I got really excited because I had a whole lot of time over the Christmas break, and I used this blank graph box for a whole bunch of master plan ideas for the month, and this is a lot more than I've actually been able to keep up with, but that's okay. So from my master plan, I narrow down three habits to build and three milestones with rewards. Habits are things that I need to be doing daily and I need to continue doing once the month ends. Like don't leave dirty dishes in the sink overnight, self-care hygiene on a schedule. Make sure that I am doing things, that I'm taking care of myself and taking care of my personal health and hygiene on a specific schedule to ensure that I'm not sitting here in the middle of the day thinking, did I take my pills? Did I brush my teeth? Did I do this? Did I do that? Or rushing to try to get things done in the middle of the day when I'm supposed to be working, which is the third habit, working that daily schedule that goes back to the master goal for this quarter. For milestones and rewards, the milestones are things that I can do all month, such as giving up fast food, except for coffee shops, of course. Have to have that coffee. Or specific things that I need to get accomplished that month, such as finding a local chiropractor and a local eye doctor, which I have been putting off since I moved here. And then each milestone comes with a reward, from something small like buying stickers and decorations for the planner, to eating out, or buying a ticket to a production at the theater that I really want to see. And I make the reward commensurate with the milestone. So finding an eye doctor, it's stickers. Finding a chiropractor, I'm going to go out to eat, which is actually kind of a separate milestone itself because that's my solo dining goal, which we're not going to talk about today. Or no fast food, which is a month-long thing, which gets a more expensive, more desirable reward. The last month's recap, I did not do this month because I had stopped using my previous planner long before December, so I didn't have anything written down to go back and look at. And then there are things from my master plan that I know I want to focus on every single month, so those actually get their own specific boxes already printed on the planner pages so that I'm not having to go in and fill those in every time and try to remember which ones I wanted to focus on all year, such as friends and family communication, local bites and sights, which is things to do, ideas of places to eat. Again, this is more of a wish list than a to-do list. A plan for my blog, a monthly theme, resources that I'm going to use, and then online post ideas. My food blog, my low-carb blog, is on hiatus this quarter until I can get my daily schedule figured out. I don't need to be focusing on too many things at once and trying to food meal plan and prep new recipes to take photos of and post on the blog just needed to be put on hold while I'm trying to get that schedule under control. To set these, again, obviously each one is a specific master plan area, but it makes me go back and look at those master plan notes that I made so that I can pull out specific ideas from that I want to actually focus on during the month. Well, and you may have noticed I have a color theme for the month. I decided that instead of color coding each category, which was making me crazy, having to either look up the colors or memorize them, I'd go with a color scheme that matched the borders that I dropped into the calendar pages before printing. And since my January snowflake border is in shades of blue and aqua, I decided to use those colors to write everything in this month. And some things are still color coded, which you'll see when we get into the week planning. But I really like the way it's turned out because it's a little more calming. It's not as frenetic as something like this, which is what I did in December, where I was trying to use all the different colors for each category. So if you can just imagine everything on here being in a different color, it just, it's not visually appealing to me. But I'll talk about that, the putting the borders in, all the color scheme stuff in another video, because that's how I plan my quarter and my month. So that's all I really need to talk about, and I need to wrap this up. If you like this content and you'd like to see more videos like this, please like and subscribe. If you have any questions about my planner or my process or writing or whatever, please let me know in the comments. And I'll see you next time.